TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 23rd of September. Indian PM Modi arrives in New York for 74th UN General Assembly. Baloch activist holds anti-Pakistan protest, seek UN intervention. And Afghanistan gears up for presidential poll amid challenges. Now for all the details, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi arrived in New York on Sunday night on the second leg of his US visit after an unprecedented and historic visit to Houston. He will address the 74th session of the UN General Assembly and participate in other multilateral and bilateral engagements over the next 5 days.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi arrived in New York on Sunday night to participate in the 74th session of the United Nations General Assembly. He will address the 74th session of UNGA and participate in other multilateral and bilateral engagements over the next 5 days. Modi arrived in New York after delivering an electrifying address in Houston to over 50,000 members of the Indian diaspora at a mega community event also addressed by US President Donald Trump. Trump hailed the India-US relationship and the Indian-American community. Making a strong pitch against terrorism, Prime Minister Modi in his address without naming hit out at Pakistan for its support to terrorism. He said India's decision to nullify Article 370 has caused trouble to those who cannot handle their country, as he called for a decisive battle against terrorism.
Samay aa gaya hai ki aatankwad ke khilaf aur aatankwad ko badhawa dene walon ke khilaf nirnayak ladai ladi jaye.
Prime Minister Modi also underscored his government's push for development in India, saying it is the most discussed word in the country. It was the first time Modi addressed a large crowd in the United States, which is home to about 4 million Indian Americans, including about 300,000 in Houston and nearby Dallas.
Indian Army Chief General Bipin Rawat on Monday claimed that the terror launch pad of Jaish-e-Mohammed in Pakistan's Balakot, which was destroyed by the Indian Air Force in February, has been reactivated.
Indian Army Chief General Bipin Rawat on Monday said that Jaish-e-Mohammed's terror camp in Pakistan's Balakot, which was destroyed by the Indian Air Force earlier this year, has been reactivated. Speaking to reporters in southern Chennai city, General Rawat also said that Pakistan violates ceasefire along the border in India's Jammu and Kashmir to push terrorists into India, and several attempts have been made recently. He said the Indian Armed Forces, however, know how to deal with ceasefire violations and will ensure that all such infiltration bids are foiled.
So obviously that shows that Balakot was affected. It had been damaged and destroyed. And that is why people had got away from there. It has now been reactivated, which just goes to highlight that yes, some action had been taken by the Indian Air Force at Balakot, and now they've got the people back there.
Tensions between the nuclear armed neighbors rose after the Indian Air Force conducted an airstrike on terror launch pad of Jaish-e-Mohammed or JEM in Pakistan's Balakot on February 26th. It came in response to killing of at least 40 Indian paramilitary personnel in a suicide bombing claimed by the JEM in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on February 14th.
Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan, who is in New York to attend the United Nations General Assembly, on Sunday met U.S. Special Envoy for Afghan Peace, Zulmay Khalilzad. Both held discussions on the failed U.S.-Taliban talks.
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan met with the U.S. Special Envoy for Afghan Peace, Zulmay Khalilzad, on Sunday in New York to discuss the failed U.S.-Taliban talks. According to a statement by the Pakistan government, the US envoy shared how far the negotiations had gone and also presented his entire analysis of the US-Taliban talks with Prime Minister Khan. Khalilzad was the chief negotiator for the US in the 9 rounds of talks with the Taliban in Doha and UAE that ultimately broke down. Earlier this month, he had announced that an agreement had been made with the Taliban in principle, but a planned meeting between the US President Donald Trump and the Taliban was cancelled after the group claimed an attack in Kabul that killed 12 people, including an American soldier. President Trump later called the peace talks dead.
Moving on, human rights activists and members of the Baloch Voice Association held a protest recently outside the United Nations office in Geneva, demanding its intervention to stop human rights violations by Pakistan in Balochistan.
Baloch activists recently held a protest at Broken Chair in front of the United Nations office in Geneva, demanding its intervention to stop human rights violations in Balochistan. Members from the Baloch Voice Association or BVA shouted slogans against the Pakistan Army and its spy agency, the Intel Services Intelligence, for kidnappings, torturing and killing of human rights activists and intellectuals from Balochistan.
The main aim of today's protest was just to raise the voices of the people who are being victimized over there back at home by the hands of the Pakistani army, by the hands of the state forces, and they are being victimized over there. And that's why we want to say that what crime they have done, that the state is, you know, so brutal against them, and for that they are paying in blood. This is what we have asked UN, that we need your intervention. The people over there in Pakistan, they need UN intervention.
Human rights defenders said that thousands of Baloch people have disappeared and their families are unable to trace their whereabouts. The activists claim that Baloch people are kidnapped by Pakistan security agencies.
Side event karte hain, hamara sirf aur sirf maqsad yahi hai ki hum Pakistani barbariyat ko, Pakistani jabr, Pakistani zulm ke guzishta 72 saalon se wo Balochistan mein kar raha hai, Balochistan par qabza karne ke baad, to hum us cheez ko yahan UNO ke muqaddas idare mein is maqsad se, is ummeed se aakar us idare ko ye batana chahte hain ki aapka khwab khargosh se bedar hokar hamare upar Pakistani barbariyat, Pakistani zulm ke upar awaaz uthaye.
Activists said that Baloch people have a lot of expectations from India that it will help them in achieving their demand and support the Baloch freedom movement. The protesters also noted that Baloch demand independence from Pakistan as it was an independent nation before 1947 and was forcibly occupied.
In news from Afghanistan, relatives and friends waited outside a hospital in Afghanistan's southern Helmand province for news of their loved ones on Monday after at least 35 civilians were killed by explosions and gunfire during a raid by Afghan government forces on a militant hideout near the venue of their wedding party. Afghan officials said the house being used by the Taliban to train suicide bombers was located adjacent to the bride's home that came under fire during the Sunday night's attack. Bombings, airstrikes and ground clashes between the US-backed Afghan forces and hardline Islamist groups have intensified recently. Meanwhile, Afghans are set to head to the polls for the presidential election on September 28th amid security concerns. The twice-delayed presidential election comes as peace talks between the US and the Taliban have collapsed and the group has vowed to attack rallies denouncing the election as a sham.
War-torn Afghanistan is preparing for the upcoming presidential election slated for September 28 amid Taliban threats and persisting challenges. The poll will be the fourth presidential election in Afghanistan since 2001, when US troops invaded the country to oust the Taliban regime. A total of 18 contestants are registered to run for the presidency with a 5-year term, and among the candidates are sitting President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah. According to a statement by the Independent Election Commission, the election officials and workers will use biometric devices on the election day in order to avoid multiple votes and identify people involved in fraud.
تمام آمادگی های کمیسیون مستقل انتخابات به خاطر برگزاری انتخابات شش میزان ریاست جمهوری به شکل عام تام گرفته شده. تمام مواد اساس و غیر اساس به تمام ولایت افغانستان انتقال داده شده و تا اکنون نزدیک به 50 ولسوالی مواد از مراکز ولایت به ولسوالی انتقال داده شده. این پروسه تا 5 میزان یک روز قبل از انتخابات ادامه خواهد داشت.
The presidential poll comes as peace talks between the US and the Taliban have collapsed, with the election shaping up as a major challenge for the country amid renewed violence and threats by the group. Officials have said over 140,000 Afghan soldiers and police will be deployed to protect 28,000 polling stations and to facilitate the process that will cost $90 million to the state exchequer and almost $60 million to foreign donors.
In news from Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena has appointed a 5-member commission to inquire into Easter Sunday attacks and report or take necessary action. More than 250 people were killed in the attacks in April.
Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena has appointed a 5-member commission to inquire into Easter Sunday bombings in April and report or take necessary action. Sirisena issued an extraordinary gazette notification on Saturday announcing the appointment of the commission. The committee would comprise 2 appeal court judges, 2 retired high court judges and a retired administrator. The panel will investigate allegations of disregarding of prior intelligence inputs on the Easter attacks and related errors which stopped authorities from taking preventive action. On April 21st, 9 suicide bombers carried out a series of blasts that tore through 3 churches and as many high-end hotels in Sri Lanka, killing at least 258 people. Though Islamic State claimed responsibility for the attacks, Sri Lankan government blamed local Islamist extremist group National Tawheed Jamaat for the bombings.
Students in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir are getting access to internet at facilitation centers set up by the authorities to fill forms for competitive exams. Internet services were partially restricted in Jammu and Kashmir after the government revoked the special status of the region last month.
Government in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir region has set up an internet facilitation centre at the Deputy Commissioner's office in Pulwama district to aid local students to fill the examination forms and entrance forms for competitive exams. The students who are eagerly thronging to avail the facilities following inconvenience caused due to the internet and communication restrictions in the region are appreciating the move. These restrictions were imposed across the region on August 4, a day before the federal government announced the abrogation of Article 370 that granted special status to Jammu and Kashmir.
यहाँ पर हमने बहुत सारे कंप्यूटर उनके लिए वक्फ किए हैं ताकि वो अपने एडमिशन फॉर्म एग्जामिनेशन फॉर्म या उनके एडमिट कार्ड है वो डाउनलोड कर सके वो फॉर्म भर सके ताकि लोगों को इस्तेफादा हो वो इंटरनेट की इससे फ़ायदा उठा सकते इस सहूलियत से और उनका कोई कीमती वक्त साल ज़ाया ना हो जाए
हमारे जो जेई मेंस के ये फॉर्म्स निकल रहे हैं उसका जो पहला शिफ्ट एग्ज़ाम हो रहा है वो अप्रैल में हो रहा है इसीलिए मुझे फॉर्म भरना था लेकिन बाहर क्योंकि ये ब्रॉडबैंड सर्विसेज और इंटरनेट अवेलेबल नहीं है इसीलिए हमको यहाँ डीसी ऑफिस में आना पड़ता है ये एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म भरने के लिए ऑनलाइन
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, after scrapping Article 370, said the move will ensure equal rights and duties for the citizens of Jammu and Kashmir. He asserted that the people of the region were being denied benefits of legislations due to the article and that it was the big obstacle to their development.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Indian PM Modi arrives in New York for 74th UN General Assembly. Baloch activists hold anti-Pakistan protest, seek UN intervention. And Afghanistan gears up for presidential poll amid challenges. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.